Hello. Hey, how's it going, everybody? We are hopping into Scrubs episode number 8. My friend, the doctor. Is that the right episode? Yep. Last episode, we'll get into that to the YouTube intro. Yeah, let's just hop in here. What's up, everybody? Stephen Hall. We're about to get another reaction. Today, we're hopping into Scrubs episode number 8 of season number 3. My friend, the doctor. Hopefully, it's a great episode. Hopefully, it's a lot of fun. Hopefully, you've been enjoying the series. Of course, if you have, like, comment, and subscribe to the channel, Patreon for the full reaction. If you want to, if not, that's totally cool. You can get episodes here whenever they show up. Previous episode was the one where it was kind of like about paying attention, where JD and Dr. Cox did not pay attention to this woman who was clearly giving signs. She was trying to harm herself. There was some other stuff there in that episode that wasn't as good as that. That was like the main takeaway, which I really liked. So this one, my friend, the doctor, I don't know, either my friend, JD's friend or Turk's friend or something. We're going to hop in here, have a good old time, have some fun. Like, comment, subscribe. Here we go.
See ya.
Karma.
Oh my God, look at that.
Perfectly vulgar.
Yeah. I think the janitor's pretending to be British.
You mean Klaus, the German guy?
Oh my God.
Guten Tag, dog.
Thanks.
What's happening?
That means nice haircut.
No, it doesn't.
Nice room beeswax.
I guess around here you have to be.
Dr. DiStefano is stuck in surgery. It's all on you, Dr. Turk.
Get a piece of cake. Who's with me? Come on.
Gotta hype him up now.
Superman.
You nailed it?
Oh. Oh,
yeah. The news of Turk's successful surgery had spread quickly. He was the stud of the hospital.
Who's the black surgeon you know that just repaired an artery like a pro?
Turk.
That's right, baby. Ooh, the doc that won't cop out when no attendings are about.
Turk.
Right on.
Turk.
What? Wow. You must be dancing on the wind right now. That is so fabulous. What is wrong with me today?
Dr. Wynn. I was scared when you didn't show up, but your car accident turned out to be the best thing that's ever happened to me.
My wife broke both her legs.
Holy shit.
Maybe it's just Buddha's way of telling her to slow.
Watch and learn. I
can be your hero. Can he dunk? You're about to hurt yourself right here. Really?
How's that taste?
Excuse me. Dude, she's got a boyfriend. Thanks, man.
Job. Wait, does
why didn't you just tell me you were a doctor?
I don't know. I guess I just still don't feel like a doctor, you know? And that whole thing with Turk today.
He's alive because of me.
I thought you said there'd be some bitches here.
We just got here. Look around. We actually had a fun night until he urinated all over my rental car.
Uh-huh. Oops. You dropped your badge. Huh. Your move there.
Oh my God, he looks so old. Bob Cox, you got it.
That's impressive.
Wait.
Kimball!
Janitor.
He's an actor.
Mr. Moran, I don't want to make
was he really in that movie, I'm guessing?
Your cellulitis is resolving nicely, and I think that you'll be out of the woods soon.
Couch.
Oh my God, now she wants to have sex?
I've been thinking about what you
said
this
morning. Oh my gosh. She must know. She must know his back is messed up.
Having enough sex lately.
Turns out, yes, we have.
No, we haven't. And tonight, we're going to do it the way you always fantasized about.
Laying down in a big tub of ice.
Standing up against the wall, you holding me up. What do you say, Romeo?
Sometimes the moment you've been waiting for comes at the most inopportune time.
Let's do this.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Sometimes the moment comes when you feel like you've been waiting for it your whole life. You just have to hope that...
Tell you, what's the habit?
What? Wait, is she mad?
Whoa. I was in a sex coma. How'd you sleep?
Oh, and Perry, I know I asked you to be more sensitive when we do it, but I was just hoping you wouldn't curse as much. I mean, to actually cry during sex. What's that about?
I guess I just love you so much. Moments? It's about saving lives. Elliot, when I put my pants on...
Yeah, I don't want to hear anything more about your pants. Look, we both know what this is about. From the second I started dating Sean, you obviously weren't happy. I thought that would change when you met someone, but I guess I've moved on and you're just acting like you have.
Wow.
Prepare for a storm off.
Cox.
Say, Carla, well, you look nice.
You're pathetic.
How's about we skip the insults and you do something helpful like prop me up or throw on a skirt?
You're an actor.
You're a fireman. What are we doing?
The other day I found a gray hair in my happy trail.
Is that the patch of hair that goes from your belly button down to your peep?
Yes, indeed.
So you have a gray happy trail. A lot of women find it distinguished.
Carla, I have a 6-month-old child. I'm going to be one of those weird old guys who brings my son.
10 years. That'll make me like 30.
40.
But you know what?
Wait, how much older is she than Turk?
It's okay.
She's
because
in her 30s.
I couldn't handle marriage until
Person
now.
Is 20,
I
right?
You when you were younger, and you would have been a horrible dad. Now, we're both ready.
But Turk isn't.
Do you think that my son will like me?
Oh. Mr. Moran is coding.
Dr. Reed.
Turk, what are you doing? Let her get it, what?
At the end of the day, medicine's pretty competitive, so I guess you have to do whatever's right for you.
Go.
Go.
There we go.
Okay, let's throw a central line. Natasha, get the crash cart. Have we established an airway?
It's obstructed.
We're going to do an emergency tray. Get the scalpel and the tourniquet. Plus.
Watching Elliot in there, I couldn't help but be impressed. She was amazing.
Go, you guys.
Unfortunately, in medicine, even if you do everything perfectly...
Oh, no, what? No, not the old man! She's gonna feel like it was her... She's gonna feel like it was her fault.
Sorry.
Hey, baby, Todd and I are going to the arcade, so I'm gonna get some quarters out the purse. Mwah.
He's rolling a...
Others eventually accept who they are.
Yeah, well, I'm older now. Would you please get me down to my damn car?
Sure, let's get your big Irish ass to your car so nobody knows that you hurt your...
All right, well, this was a good, solid episode. I don't think it was great or anything, but I think that the overall message was pretty rock solid. I actually liked the message, where no matter... Sometimes you... need to be okay with what's happening in your life. Growing old, not being the hero. You know, always have dreams and aspirations, which is what was happening with the janitor. I don't know. I like the episode. I'll probably give it a 7. I feel bad for Elliot. She's still with that guy, though. She's still with Sean. What's his name? Whatever that guy's name is. I'm pretty sure she's still with him. I mean... I don't. I constantly talk about JD and Elliot's relationship. I don't know how many of you guys really ever. Cause most people don't really comment on the Scrubs that often. I'm not really sure how many of you guys actually feel the way I feel about that relationship. I always mention it, and I feel like if you guys disagreed a lot with what I was saying, that you guys would comment. And you know, you guys comment on certain things, but Elliot JD thing is something that I constantly, I don't know, for me, it's not, I would really prefer if they don't end up together. Like, this episode to me was perfect for what they do, for like how they act with one another. They're friends, right? They're like best friends. Well, they're all three best. I mean, JD is best friends with her and with Turk, but the way that he was, like the way that he competed with her, ran there, got it, but then when he knew that was bothering her, he let her win to get to the patient first to have her moment. And then when you think it's going to go well and she's going to have her moment, she doesn't have her moment. And he says sorry, and I don't know. I thought that was fascinating. We have Dr. Cox with his whole situation where he's getting older and he's still trying to feel young and do things like he's young. Doesn't really work. You know, what's that saying? Father Time, like, there's a saying that you can't escape Father Time or something like that. Then we had the stuff with JD and the janitor, like I said, and him wanting the janitor kind of pretending to be somebody else always. And the reason was because the janitor wanted to be something. He had dreams, he had aspirations. I don't know, I like that. I like when the show goes that route more than when it goes wacky. I like the wacky when it's mixed in with seriousness. But we'll go through here. We'll kind of start at the beginning. Carla, she wants to have kids. She wants to kind of move into that stage of her life. But she's dating a guy that's mid-20s probably. And, you know, kind of seeing how Kirk handles even the conversation of kids. We had some stuff with the relationship. With the relationship with his girlfriend. But I guess that's why JD isn't. No, he still is, because he thought about her. He's dating somebody. I don't know. This is with the whole stuff with the janitor. Kirk, you know, had to do a surgery by himself, became kind of a hero. Cox messes up his back trying to show off. We have the whole stuff with the janitor again. This guy was hitting on her. She went through a bunch of different obstacles and didn't get to the point about her being a doctor. She explains that it's because she hasn't had her moment yet. What's the joke here?
I was just made partner at my law firm.
Bitches here.
Oh, this is bitches here. Dr. Cox was still pretending like his back doesn't hurt and doing the whole bend over thing. These girls watching The Fugitive. Him seeing that the guy is in The Fugitive. Has there ever been a show where an actor in one show was actually in a movie? Or like anything like this has ever happened where they reference him as an actor in another thing? That's kind of fascinating. We have the whole sex thing when she tried to give Cox what he wants. JD rushes to get to the patient, ends up saving the patient's life. Aaliyah gets mad throughout the episode because, you know, she wanted the moment. JD says it's not about the moment, it's about saving lives. She says, you did that because you can't get over me or something. Well, Carla didn't really realize anything at the end. She realizes she's ready, but even at the end, she just realized she's old. How old is Carla? Is Carla in her 40s in the show? Because Dr. Cox is in his late 40s. Gotta be. But like, how old, I always think Carla's like 33, 34. Maybe she's older. We have the old man who was really nice to Elliot. We then have JD hear the sequence where he just can't stop thinking about Elliot in that sexual way. Talk about getting older and stuff like that. And her realizing that she's dating somebody that's really young and immature. And that, you know, she's ready to have a family and stuff. And when that's going to happen. When JD lets Elliot get to the patient first, no matter what she did, didn't work out well. She ended up still not getting the, not saving the guy's life. And then we have the whole thing about the JD wishes that he was the actor in The Fugitive because it would mean that the janitor had aspirations and dreams when he was younger. That's it. And then Elliot kind of just says she's a doctor at the end there. So that's the episode. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it. If you did, like, comment, subscribe, Patreon for the full reaction. I'm going to get out of here and talk to you guys later.